This lab is revised from SEED 2.0 cross-subscripting attack lab, so please open its official website, then we will complete task 1 to task 5 described in the lab manual. Here it is. This lab we will use containers. If you have any trouble with the containers, please refer to this Docker manual to solve those problems. To avoid any conflicts, I usually delete all previous containers before I start a new lab. So this is a lab description. First, we need to set up the lab environment with this lab setup.zip. So let's download this one. Save link as. Lab 09. Unzip. Okay, we have two images, one for the ELK website, the other one for the database. Open a terminal here. If you have any trouble because container conflict, please remove all your previous containers. I put some tips in lab 08. Right here, can I use these tips to remove any previous containers and images. Remove all containers. Then remove all images. This will give you a clean environment. Okay, all my other images and containers are removed. Now I'm going to build the containers we are going to use today. DC build under our lab setup folder. You should see two folders and one file here. DC build. We need to set up the DNS. After we build up these containers, we may open a new tab, sudo gedit etc/hosts. Okay, check the section. XSS lab. You can see we have all these except the first one. So you can copy this one. Paste it here. Ctrl S, save it. This is used for SEED 1.0. 2.0 is updated to this name. Container setup, I think it's built. It's built now. DC up. Okay, two containers are brought up. A new tab. Docker shell, docker ps, to see the container IDs of these two containers. The website, the search website, is hosted on this container. So I think it's a good idea to open it in background, to open this one. Close it. You can open it like this, suppress all the errors, put in background. At the end of the lab, open any new tab or new terminal window, run this DC down to close all your containers. Because in this lab, we don't need to go into the containers. If you want to go into the terminal to have a look, you can use DC shell. For example, if you want to go into the server website container, may use a doc shell. To get A4, please pay attention, I just have the first two characters because they are different from this one. Actually, we just type an A is good enough. Now you see this one is identical to that one. So this is a social website container. Now the application is hosted here. We just set up the DNS subnet, DNS name and its IP address in the host's file. Just set up it here and save it. Now we can open it in a new tab in the browser. We are familiar with this Arab social website since we practiced one lab last week. If you don't want the database, for example, if you are practiced this lab before, you don't want those data you put inside the database, you may run this one and restart your container. Here are the username and password, the accounts. Now let's go through these labs. Lab preparation, getting familiar with HTTP headline we've already used in our last lab. Right? Open this one. Then some website, interact with some website, you will get the interaction show up here. If you want more information, go to that section 5.1. Now let's go through these tasks from task 1 to task 5 today. Task 1, posting a malicious message to display an alert window here. Again, please don't copy this code from the PDF file and paste in your ELK website, because it may contain some weird character invisible characters. There are two ways. You can put this code in the short description field. If you want to run a long JavaScript, you can put it into a file. myscripts.js, then put this snippet in that short description field by any other attackable text field. For example, Sammy want to attack Alice, Charlie, and Sammy. Login. Now in his profile, add to profile. In the short description, brief description, or this about me, he put this code script alert XSS. Typed here. Script alert attacker with cross-site scripting. Okay, now saved. And you see it worked, right? Attack with XSS. Now log out. Logging as anyone, for example, Alice. If Alice check Sammy's profile, she will be attacked. Attack with XSS. Is Sammy. Attack with XSS. And you see when we list that member, that profile is also loaded. That's why you will be attacked here, even you just list these members. It also attack Sammy himself, so this is not a good idea. So we will see how to refine the attack, only attack others, not yourself. Profile. Remove that code. And save it. So this is a taskbar. However, in order to get an XSS attack, if you use this way, you also need to find a place on the same website to save this JavaScript. Here, if you put it from any other website, for example, any website other than this this seed server, this may not work because you may set some countermeasure may be set up. But here, the countermeasure is disabled, the CSP is disabled, so you can attack. Put the JavaScript on any web server. On task 2, posting a malicious message to display cookie. You may use this code. The objective of this task to embed this JavaScript program in your help profile. Anyone else views your profile, his or her cookie will be displayed in this alert window, document.cookie. So similarly, you just do it here. For example, you put it in this about me script. Please pay attention, you need to change it to HTML editor, not the visual editor. Currently I'm in HTML editing mode. Alert document.cookie. I now save it. And you see Sammy is attacked. I mean, Sammy's cookie pvisit error. These two cookies are showing up. Maybe you need to take a note to see the difference between Sammy's cookie and anyone else's cookie, for example, Alice. But if Alice check Sammy's profile, She will, her cookies in this session is showing up. See the p visitor and the elk. So it's better take two screenshots to compare Alice's cookies with Sammy's own cookies when Sammy logged into his account. We log out and then remove that one. You can remove that later. The task 2. Task 3, stealing cookies from the victim's machine. Now, how do we steal cookies from the victim machine? Which means we want to send the cookie to some other place, right? To the attack's machine here. The malicious JavaScript code written by the attacker can print out the user's cookie in task 2, but only the user can see the cookies, not the attacker. And in this task, the attacker wants JavaScript code to send the cookie to him or herself. So may I use this trick with the image tag. We know the image tag, it will send this request automatically. Let's send this source. And we know the attack's machine. This one sends this cookie to this polymer number of the attack's machine with this IP address. And the attacker has a TCP server listening to the same port. So we may use a netcat or NC to listen to it. Okay, now let's open a new tab. Here is an attacker. NC listen to file. You may choose the port number as you like. So now it's listening. We log into as Sammy the attacker. Profile. Here you see we cannot see those JavaScript because country is in visual mode. So you can just type a message like you type in your Word. So edit the HTML. Now we need to change this one to send. Document.write. Image tag. Please don't use a copy and paste. HTTP. So this port number must be identical to the port number you are listening. to escape. Escape some weird characters in the cookies. Okay, if that does not work, you need to check whether you have any typos. Image source. You need to make sure this port number is the number you are listening here. Now let's save it. Okay, your profile was successfully saved. Now let's log out. And log in as Alice. Here you check this one. Sam's own cookie is stolen and same here. See this cookie. P visitor and that L. So we need to listen it again. Now Sam knows it worked. For example, to steal Alice's cookie. If Alice checks Sam's profile, she will be attacked. So this is Alice's cookie. Can compare with Sam's cookie. Can see the difference. Here this P visitor. It looks like the peer visitor is identical. But this elk are different. Elk. Okay, this is how do you steal the cookies? Let's log out Alice. Task 4 and task file, the code template are provided. All you need to do is find GUID. You need to modify and those post requests as we did in our last lab in the CSRF attack with the HTTP header live. And the attacker purpose are also identical but with different techniques. In this level we use cross-site scripting. In our last lab we use CSRF, right? Okay, the onload means when all those HTTP the document elements loaded and ready, then this script will be executed. If we put the script, if we don't use this window.onload, it will be executed, but maybe some elements, for example those cookies, may or maybe not ready. So that's why we use this window.onload to execute this JavaScript after the web page are loaded completely. We put this code in the about me. Now what do we need to modify? The HTTP request to add Sammy as a friend get method. Quick explain the purpose of line 1 and line 2. Why are they needed? Here, line 1, line 2. The tokens, you know these tokens are used to feedback or as a countermeasure against CSRF. That's why we need this one, 9192. Question 2 only provides the at mode for the about me field. For example, you cannot switch to the text mode. Can you still launch a successful attack? Not from this about me field, maybe we can find some other text field. You know, on the profile, there are so many text boxes, so you need to try them one by one to see which text boxes are attackable. So now the template is provided in our lecture. So we go there and copy those code, copy the template. Module 2 code here, addFriends.js, right? This is addFriends.js. What you need to add it is this request and the GUID. Now, this GUID is attacker's GUID. So we use the raw mode and the Ctrl+A, Ctrl+C. Certainly, you can use any way you like to download this JavaScript code. Just use this manual way to download. Now, create a text file, touch, add friends. .js. And open it in GEditor. Suppress the arrows. Ctrl V, paste it here. Ctrl S, save it. Actually, since we will copy and copy this thing and paste it in the profile for me text box. First thing, we already know the website name is changed. Let's change it to this one. You already know how to use HTTP headline in our last lab, so I will not repeat that. We know it's this one. Action friends add. Now, the friend ID. We need to find Sammy's GUID. We log in as Sammy. Add his profile. Bottom, you see that is the image over there. So that's why you need to set his height or width. And width both to 1, then that is only a single pixel. It's uneasy to notice, but this is easy to notice, right? It's an image. So, change to add the HTML mode. Remove this one. We want to find Sammy's GUID. Right click, view the source code. Scroll down, you will see Sammy's GUID. It's 59. So you can change this one to 59. Now you can use Ctrl+A, Ctrl+C, copy the whole content, go to Sammy's profile, now you can paste it here, pay attention, you need to switch to edit HTML. That toolbar disappeared, right? Here, the visual mode, the toolbar is here. Toolbar disappeared. Can't we paste here? Now, the problem is, Sammy will be attacked as well, because this frame is 59. So, which means Sammy will add himself as his frame. Save it. Now you check Sammy's friend list friends. No friends yet. Profile. Visited. Refresh. Okay, it looks like that bug is removed. In seed 1.0, Simon will add himself as his friend. Now let's log into Alice to see whether Alice will be attacked or not. Logged in. Check Simon's profile. Simon's profile. Back to her profile. Check her friends. No friends yet. It looks like that code we paste. This one didn't work. So let's see what's the problem. Here is a problem, I didn't modify all the stuff. Okay, I think you may put in several lines with this concatenation. Ctrl A, Ctrl C, do it again. Log in as Sammy. Modify his profile. Alt profile. Ctrl A delete. Ctrl V paste here. Now save it. Successfully saved. I just click on refresh. See friends? No friends yet. Login as Alice and check Sammy's profile. Okay, it looks like Alice is not attacker. And check Alice's friend list, no friend yet. So it looks like maybe because the template is provided for seed 1.0. For seed 2.0, we need to check the add friend. Sammy. No. To find the add friend request, For example, at Charlie, we use the HTTP head live add frame. Okay, now we get this request. Check our code. Here is the token ArcTS. ArcTS is here, and ArcToken. ArcToken is here. We use a web name. Now for the request here, sales server action friends add. Right? And plus that token, and plus this timestamp. So it looks good. Then we create and send the AJAX request. We know this is a GET method. So request header. And send it. Okay, I didn't see any problem in this code. Let's host here. CSL.com. Let's close this one. Get send your error. Sure. Here, this is a new version. Does not contain that set header here. Set request header. The two set request header is removed. And this one is exactly the same. Send your error. So what's the problem I made? Let's comment out these two. I don't think these two are fact. Can you see? Let's remove the frame. Okay, Sunny, editor, this text script again. Comment out these two. Right? No frame for himself. Okay, it looks like this attack. Doesn't all look. This is for the get method. I will check why it does not work. What's the problem? How about the task file? Let's go through task file to have a look. Modify the victim's profile. Set request header. So those two comments does not matter, looks like. We need to answer these questions. Why do we need line 1? You remove this line and repeat your attack. Here, this line 1 will attack himself. Sam is your ID. In my case, it's 59. Yours may be different. Okay, now let's try this task file. Add the profile. Ctrl A, Ctrl C. Come back here. Add the profile. Open with the G editor. Ctrl V, paste here. So we know Sam's GID. Here is the user's GID. Sam's GID we know is 59. So you may use a variable to make it more readable. Right? Sam's GID equals 59. So please pay attention, yours may be different. Again, I also need to change this one. Do you think I need to put an HTTP here? In the edit profile. So we suppose the post are identical to what we need, what we used in CSRF attack, right? Just like that get method. So here the description, Sam is my hero, up to you to modify to anything else. So we only need to modify this part, 39 and this one. Okay, Ctrl A, Ctrl C. Go to Sammy's. Edit the profile. Here there is a HTTP, right? We can add a HTTP to see if this work or not. Successfully saved. It looks like it does not work. See, I missed that HTTP. In this add front, here I have the HTTP, now it worked. It looks like this bug is not removed. He added himself as his friend, Sam is a friend himself. Now He cannot remove this one. Okay, Sammy, you cannot remove yourself from yourself's frame list. That is the way you can remove it. You may refer to our course companion website to remove yourself from your frame list. I think it's in lab 10 maybe. You can check lab 10, yes. In lab 10, you can remove oneself from his or her frame list. You need to go to the database. For example, in our container, the database is this one, is this container. So you can open a new tab, let's doc sh, go to this database container. Cashier. So you are inside the database container. Now you can run these commands: mysql dash root dash p seed ubuntu. Access denied. Dash p seed Ubuntu is not echoed back. Using password, yes, access denied. So. Password may be different. Let's check this lab manual. Seed erg. For that MySQL database password, so what's that? Maybe the password is changed. Okay, you may check Seed's lab setup to find the database password, the root password. Then you can follow this lab 10 to remove oneself from his or her friend list. So we can do it in lab 10. Currently, we just leave Sammy as his old friend. It does not matter. Now we know this get method work to add yourself to some other's friend list without his or her consent. Will Sammy want to add himself to Alice's friend list? If Alice checked Sammy's profile, now she is an attacker, can check her friends. I see Sammy is in her friends list. I will lock out and practice the signal attack to modify others' profile. I log in as Sammy, modify edit profile, switch to HTML here. Delete. Now we need the second edit profile.js. Make sure your Sammy's still ID is your Sammy, not my Sammy. They may be different. If this field 9 is not your Sammy's, you will see a pop up as we saw in one of our lectures. Now Sammy pastes the code here to modify someone else's profile, but he will not modify his own profile because this sentence. Okay, it's saved. Now let's log in as Alice. Log out. Submit. Log in as Alice. If Alice check Sammy's profile, well, her profile will be modified. Right? Sammy is my hero. Is modified or attacked. Okay, once you are done your lab, please remember run DC down in this lab setup folder to shut down your containers elegantly.